Hello.
So I'm live. Can you hear me? Is the microphone working? Cool. Sure, it's turned off. So drafter. Yay. Whoa, what was that? I heard something. I don't know what I just heard. Anyways. Not doing the league. Their flashback is not good again. Alright. Let's get over to the Mikko screen here. And it's not showing Mikko. Hey, that works out well. Cool. Expand this out. And a little wider. There we go. How's everyone doing today? So I thought about it, and by the way, the Shards of Alara Conflux, kind of interests me. Kind of doesn't. Alara was okay, but I need to practice for this weekend for Shadow. Well, I have a Tournament of Champions that's happening this Saturday, and it's invitation only. I have to be one of the top 16 people that draft at the store that I draft at, and I am easily in the top 16. So, and that's in Planeswalker points. So and it'll be a triple Shadows of Ringstrad draft, since that's what's current. So, well, as much as I'd love to be full screen, I have to do partial screen. So I'm going to get in the queue here for this. Looks like it's cutting off the bottom of the screen just a little bit. There we go. I do see someone watching me. Hello. Join me in the chat on twitch.tv/chuckaw1977. I need to broadcast up that I am streaming on Twitter. Ha. Tools. Share. Share it. Yeah. Post it to Twitter. So, three in the queue right now. Hopefully, we get a few more people. If you're in the chat, have any of you played any Pokemon Go? I downloaded it today. Pending invitations, all chat rooms. Wait, what? Okay. So, I'm a level 3 trainer now, with 5 Pokemon. I have a Caterpie, a Ghastly, a Krabby, a Pidgey, and my starter was a Charmander. And I'm looking around right now. I'm at home right now. And looking around, it doesn't look like there's any Pokemon around me. That's awkward. Oh, I need to. Oh, thank you, Peekaboo. If you're watching, thank you for retweeting me there. Turn on the Wi-Fi. Maybe that'll help some. It says there's only Pidgeys around me right now. I don't know. I find the app very interesting. What's going on here? Am I just in a devoid area of Pokemon? My workplace is near a Pokecenter, apparently. But I can't go until I'm level 5. Oh, wait, why are you walking around? Okay. I'm not sure why you're walking around. That's not where I'm at anyways. Okay. Well, it's trying to do something. There may have been some people that are having issues with it today. I know I've had some issues with it today. For a while there couldn't connect and other stuff like that, so... I don't know. It seems interesting. All I've been able to do is, like, I've caught a few Pokemon, and I don't have anything to do with it, so... There's that. So... Wow, this is taking forever to fill this queue. While we wait, go back to the opening here. I'm gonna pull up. Let's see if there's mentioning any Pokemon Go. See if there's any issues. I know some people authenticate trainer club progress, GPS and other issues plaguing players. All kinds of server issues. So today may not have been a good day to join Pokemon Go. That's funny. I mean, it's not, because like so many people... Let's see. Are you able to check out all the troubleshooting tips? Oh, they got a video. I don't want the video. It's going to play the video anyways. Oh, well, it didn't load the flash plugin. I'm gonna authenticate. No. Don't wanna play the video. I said I didn't want to play the video. So yeah. Oh wait, here we go. We're going to drive. Here we go. Let's open some good stuff here. Good stuff. Alright, so... What else is in here? Watching the web vessel. Alright. Well, it's a rare. It's hard to deal with. Kinda. This pack is actually kind of awful. I really don't like hardly any of this. The best card in here might be Moonlight Hunt. Near Heath Chaplain isn't horrible. 3-1 for 4 that I can get 2 spirit tokens when it dies. That's not awful. But if I'm going to do that, I might as well just take the Moondrakes here. None of these are good to start with. Not for first pick. I don't even want to take. Alright, I took the Moondrakes. What? Well, new plan. New plan. Westvale Abbey token generation. What did they take? They took... Whatever was in the place of a common, so a foil something. Westvale Abbey, get in, you're in. Alright, so don't care about Spirit Wolf. What I do care about is getting as many little creatures in the battlefield as possible. Dance with the Devils, you're good for that. Open the armory, not so good for this. I mean, it's removal. I could just Insolent Neonate's interesting. I kind of want to go super aggressive here. And Insolent Neonate does that. That is removal. And it helps Delirium. But I kind of want to go the aggressive route here. Love Fleeting Memory is not going to happen. Deadweight is good. I just take Deadweight in this case. Crow is interesting. Structural distortion hates me. Best card in the pack is probably Twins. Yeah, I take Twins here. Gollum. Furtive Homunculus isn't horrible either. It's early drop. Again, another structural distortion I hate seeing those at the table. I'll take the Homunculus. Let's see what we go here with this. Well, Triskaidekaphobia is funny. Another Insolent Neonate. Sanitarium Skeleton. These are all not bad cards to have. I'm going to take the Skeleton. Insolent Neonate, I've got one. I feel like I can get a couple more of those without any real problems. So, don't know that we're on the blue plan. Black seems better. Well, oh, this is my pack. This is kind of awful. I'm going to take the Grotesque Mutation. Not sure I'm playing Homunculus yet. Not sure I'm playing Moondrake. Plural. Kind of want this to be kind of an aggressive deck here. What I'd love to get, is called Bloodline. And then just go Vampires with Westfield Abbey. Biting Rain, Vampire Noble. I'm going to go Vampire Noble here. Biting Rain's good against me, not going to lie. Macabre Waltz. I guess I'll go with the Pyre Hound here. I guess I'll take an Open the Armory, throw it in the sideboard. Yeah, I'll take the Homunculus. Well, there's a foil swamp. Take it. And a sweet island. Alright, so let's see what I open here. What is going on? I love this. Okay. I've got a plan. I have a plan. It involves Westvale Abbey and Nahiri the Harbinger. That's the plan. I need to get. There's no white in this, so I cut off white in this deck, but I definitely take that. By the way, wow. Wow. Yeah, it's just the Thalia's here. Well, that's kind of what Westvale Abbey wants. Thalia's Lieutenant doesn't really do anything for me right now. I can splash white from here. And there's the splash white if I want to do that. What else is in here? Nothing I care about. Forsaken Sanctuary, get it. Sin Prodder. You certainly... You're an interesting choice here. I think I take the Murderous Compulsion. I like Sin Prodder, don't get me wrong. But being able to take away my Westvale Abbey or my Nahiri from my it seems bad. I'm going to take the Murderous Compulsion. I like Sin Prodder, but I don't think it's right for what I'm trying to do in this deck. Behind the scenes, Incorrigible Youth is probably the play here. Blood Man's not awful either. But I think Incorrigible Youth is just a better card. Nahiri's Machinations is very interesting. Pale Rider is also actually much better. I take the Pale Rider in this situation. These are really three drops. Again, splashing white for Nahiri, not an awful thing to do in this deck. Probably not playing Thalia's Lieutenant. It just doesn't do anything for me. God, another structural distortion? God damn it, people are going to hate me. Probably just our twins. It's fodder for the Call of the Bloodline. It's kind of what I'm doing. Rancid Rats, sure. Stromkirk is probably what I want to do here. Or Tormenting Voice. Probably just Stromkirk. Although Tormenting Voice, if I can get one in the next, if I can get one, that's not a bad card for me. I don't think Thalia's Lieutenant gets it added. Forsaken Sanctuary to splash from the area. Seems fine. I've got 10 creatures. So, Westvale Abbey, which is crazy good. And Nahiri, which is crazy good for a Planeswalker. So, probably open Jace in the next pack? I don't know. This is ridiculous. This is not helping me for my draft coming up this weekend. If I'm taking anything out of this, it's Dual Shot. Because I can actually use that. I hate that vessel. Take that away some surgery. Can't really deal with that. Behind the scenes is interesting. I'm going to put it in the deck for now. But I don't think I play that. Okay. So, aggressive. I'm okay with aggressive. This is good. Vampires and this wants to be aggressive. I wouldn't mind more token generators. Another Call of the Bloodline would be amazing. Angel of Deliverance. Cryptolith Rite. That's interesting. I could just take the Stone Quarry. There's not a lot here for me. Nahiri's Machinations is fun, but I don't think that really does anything for me. I'm going to highlight Stone Quarry here. Angel Deliverance, I'll let someone else have that. That seems really hard for that to happen. And here's Machinations might be the pick here. I don't want to run out of that. I'd rather have the Stone Quarry in this instance. I know I'm running Nahiri, so. Griffspoon's good. Angelic Purge is good. Ooh, Fiery Temper. And, oh, wow, this pack. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four great cards. Pack Guardian's not horrible. Cult is not horrible. But for what I'm wanting to do, Murderous Impulsion's fine. I kind of just want the Fiery Temper here. I think I can get another Murderous Compulsion. Well, Air of Falcon Wrath, you're going to get in the deck. Throttle's not a horrible card to have. But no, it's Air of Falcon Wrath. Kindly Stranger. That's removal. I'm not really doing the... The problem with this is I'm not really doing Delirium with this deck. I probably just want the Ravenous Bloodseeker. It's probably going to be Geese's Bidding here. Because again, I'm wanting to get as many creatures out as possible for Westvale. And that does it. Ghoulcaller's Accomplice isn't horrible either. But with Madness, I can do that. I can do Geese's Bidding. Three mana for two zombies that come in untapped. That seems fine. Ghoulsea is not great. Strom Kirk Winter is kind of what I want to do. I've got 12 creatures, though. Tormenting Voice is honestly. To go searching for what I want, Tormenting Voice is kind of what I want here. Plus, like I said, more discard out what's to be able to play the madness on these creatures. It's probably Olivia's Bloodsworn in this instance. Yeah. That's kind of what the deck wants. Behind the scenes can get out. Pyrehound probably gets out next. Depending on what I can get here. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding? Really? Oh, holy hell! No, get in the deck. Wow. I've been handed a deck, let me tell you. Compelling Deterrence is kind of awful against us. Hearing's Machinations is pretty good, actually. I'm going to take Nahiri's Machinations. I probably don't cut it, though. Of these cards, what do I want? I'm going to take Farbog. Not probably going to play it. Pick the Brain, picks away at my stuff, so not going to play it, though. Not really in that deck. I got all kinds of... Pyrehound probably gets out. For what I'm trying to do... I'll take the fixing. I don't need it, though. Merciless Resolve. It draws cards, but I don't really want it. Clip Wings. Don't care about that. And an island. So... Gotta cut one. Added... What? What's going on? I shouldn't be... Why am I... I don't know what just happened. I hope I'm still in this tournament. That's weird. Alright, so... Dual Shot's kind of not what I want in this deck. But this stuff is all pretty good. 14 creatures, 9 spells. Two of those put in creatures. One of those is an enchantment that puts in creatures. And one of them draws me cards and triggers the madness. I love this deck. Nahiri being in it is a nice plus. Having Nahiri is a nice plus in this. But this is definitely the deck here. I play Forsaken Sanctuary for sure, Stone Quarry, Westvale Abbey, and then maybe one white source? Oh, get the swamp in, get the mountain in. Alright, let's see what it recommends. It says no white sources. I can live with that. Some more swamps. Yeah, that's fair. Let's see here. 4, 5, 6. I'm gonna bump that up to 7. There's a few cards I want the red early for. That gives me 7 red sources. This is 6, 7, 8 black sources and 2 white. All right. Add that to the deck. This deck is awesome. Pale Rider is even good, even though it doesn't really fit with this. I wish I had a second skeleton. I really do. I didn't see a lot, so someone else is doing that. I like this deck. Oh, wait. 16 lands? Oh, I need an inner land. Four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, that's fine. Alright. 17 land, 14 creatures, 9 spells. Submit this. I don't know why it did that. That's so weird that it gave me the product already. So I got a few things that I was missing. Dance with the Devils is a really nice pickup here in this deck. Because again, most of these are pretty low drop creatures. This is pretty much a one drop. This is a three. This is a three. This is a three. Hopefully this is a three. I like this curve. This curve is nice. This is actually a quite good deck. I can't believe I got Westvale Abbey passed to me. This is one of those cards. You probably, if you're ever drafting, probably should never pass this card. Let's make it to where everyone can see it here. It's a land, so it comes in, you can use its abilities right away. You can tap it for colorless mana. Not great reset, but okay. You can pay 5 and tap it and pay a life, and you can put a 1-1 white and black human cleric creature token onto the battlefield. Okay, not great. You're paying 5 and a life to get a creature. Or for 5 and tap it and sacrifice 5 creatures. You transform it, and it becomes Ormondal, Profane Prince, and it comes in untapped after it transforms, with flying, lifelink, indestructible, and haste. This card is disgustingly good. This is a nice open. Nahiri the Harbinger, very nice open. By the way, she's batshit insane. She apparently is the one who brought Embercool to the plane of Innistrad. She's insane. What I like, with one of the cards I spoiled today, I'm going to go check it out. Just real quick. Mythic Spoiler. There we go. That's right here. So, with one of the cards I spoiled with this, new set, which they spoiled quite a bit. They've spoiled 104 of the 205 cards. But one of the cards they spoiled, and I don't know if it was today or if it was a previous day. What was it called? I'm going off the top of my head here. There's a card. Oh, no, I think it was a blue card. Turn aside. No. It has the moon in it. It's something up high, I think. Oh, here it is. Imprisoned in the Moon. So, reading this. Enchant creature, land, or planeswalker. Enchanted permanent is a colorless land with tap, add colorless mana pool to your mana pool, and loses all other card types and abilities. Oh, they're waiting for me. I'm going to extend this out a bit. Wow. Alright. Yes, I would like to play first. And this seems actually quite bad for us. I'm gonna look at this. This seems a whole lot better. Yeah, I'm keeping this. That will go on top. Alright, so play out Swamp so I can play Deadweight. Although it's not instant speed, so whatever. Green, interesting. Alright, well, I'm going to play Aerith Falconwrath here. And the next turn... Oh, that's not Madness. Never mind. I thought that was a Madness card for some reason. He has nothing. Okay. Well, let's see what he chooses to do here. I don't have a good target for my for discard, so. And combat. Alright. Push him to shove. I can always flip it if he decides to do one damage to it. Militant Inquisitor. Interesting. Wow, that seems awful. This is not what I was looking for. I could just play a Pale Rider here. I could play Deadweight on it. And just swing and he does nothing. Any block he does kills him. So that's fine by me. This isn't a great start, not gonna lie. Deadweight on this is not horrible, though. If he plays out some sort of equipment, it means it's not gonna be very big. Abyssinian Missionary, sure. Okay. So that is not what I was looking for. Well, I think I just keep back everything, play out devils. So you must be playing some sort of equipment thing, because Abyssinian Missionaries is really good if you can equip it with an equipment. So he's got to be playing some equipment in his hand. He's got to have something. He's going to swing with that. But I will put Dance with the Devils out. Okay. Now we're cooking with fire. Do that. Discard a card. Okay. And I will happily pay for that. I wish I had a little more mana. Because Westvale just about flips. And yes, I would like to. Boom. Boom. Boom, boom. Probably should have kept red up, but whatever. This guy is taking forever. Okay, transform that. And now I got a blocker for Abyssinian Missionaries. I can play Indulgent Aristocrat, sack the two devils, Rabbit Bite. Okay. Okay, well. That's fine. You can't attack. I guess you could. You can kill everything I have with the puncturing light. Puncturing light would wreck me, but what I'm going to block with is the two devils. So that I get rid of your Avacyn and missionaries and your... Or do I just... I don't care. I'm so far ahead in this game. Alright. So, I play this. And then I can just sack the devils, give all my vampires plus one counters. That seems fine. Now I'm safe from puncturing light with my twins. I can block his missionaries without any problems. Oh, he's doing something here. Oh, he's exposing evil on both of us. Alright, that's fair. Fair enough. I still block with the devil. I'd like to keep it. Make my guys bigger. Yeah, he was pretty screwed there. He's not playing red. He's playing green. Dual shot doesn't look like it did anything. He's playing light green. I don't have a reason to bring in anything right now. Pick the brain. Not really caring about that. Merciless result. No. I'm going to do this. Fire it back. Alright. This is a hand. Alright. Keep this. I keep back Pale Rider until I have 4 mana so I can Murderous Compulsion something. Probably Mountain first or Swamp first. It could be Swamp first if he plays something stupid first turn. It's white. Is he going to play Thraben Inspector? Thraben Inspector? You, sir, are taking quite a bit of time for this first turn. Okay. Did we lose him? He's still there. Hello? Hello? Nope, let's get me walking again. Since I'm sitting here waiting, I might as well check out Pokemon Go, see if it's working any better. Again, no Pokemon here. The maps are pretty. Alright, come on. $5.39 plays plate. So we've sat here 2 minutes after their draw. Or after they played the planes. Oh, hey, we're moving again. He goes to unstep. Nothing. Well, I'll play the insolent neonate first. That seems fine. Nothing, huh? Alright, well. I'll keep back Pale Rider if I get flooded out here a little. Oh, look. Alright. That's cute. Get in for two? Yeah, that's what Mama likes. Sure. Alright, so here's the thought. So I could just Pale Rider, Madness and Murderous Compulsion, which seems fine. That's actually what I'm just going to do. Okay. Okay, you got my guy. You're gonna gain three. That's annoying, but I can always double it. All right, so but then you have to spend pretty much your whole turn doing that. Are you double queuing? Is that what's going on here? Farbar Revenant isn't a horrible play here. But I kind of like the idea of attacking him with Insolent Neonate, Madnessing, and Twins. Keep cards in hand. I'm gonna make him think. Emissary, okay. That's not great for me. Get in for five. He can only get in for two. Rabbit Bite doesn't kill the insolent, or not the incorrigible youths. Sure, you get me for two. I go to 13. I'm cracking back for five. Oh, you're putting two? Sure. that's fair. Put him in Firebog Revenant. So... only thing that can block it are, the Firebog are these two spirits. And with that, I'll give life. He can swing in for four. Get me to nine. He's got to have an answer, though. Because I swing back for five, six. Let's see if he's got an answer. He must have an answer in hand. All right, well, I'm not blocking anything. So let's see what he does here. Is he pumping his team with tenacity? That seems like something that should be done. But on his turn. Well, now he doesn't have tenacity, so... a 3-3. Okay. And I think I just swing with everything. If he wants to block the incorrigible youth with the Abyssinian missionaries, I'm all for it. I'm going to gain a life. Oh, what's he doing? Strength of arms. Doesn't control an equipment. That does just kill my guy. That's fine. I gain a life. His crackback's 3, 6, 7. Well, except for twins blocks Abyssinian missionaries pretty easily here. Oh, well. That could be a blowout now. Still can't attack with Abyssinian missionaries. Alright, so no cards in hand, so no tricks. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. So he'll get in for 7. Okay. Well, I swing in with this. It potentially kills both of them because he's going to have to double block on that. Otherwise, I can gain 7. And can I just play this out too? 5, 6, 7. Yes, I can. All right, well. Okay. Your only block is either double block him or block him with something in chunk. Double block him, I'm going to discard twins. Which shuts down. I'm okay with this. Okay. So I go back to 10. He can only crack back for 4. Having another twins in hand was pretty nice there. Oh, well, byway courier, sure. Cracking in for 4 gets me to 6. Alright, well. I go back up to 7 with this. Okay. I crack back 4. 5, he blocks this with this. So I only get in for 2, but I gain 1 to 7. Okay. That's super awkward. But. Okay. So. How do I go about doing this? He can only swing in for 4. Alright, that seems fine. 2 doesn't seem to do anything. He can't block anything. I can't discard that. Well, probably do like I did before. Swing in with these two, gain life. I go to 4. Discard a card to draw a card. Well, that does literally nothing for me. I needed some sort of removal for these. That's what I needed for the flyers. I needed removal. I think I just go concede the game, go to the next game, because I can't deal with the flyers. Alright. Flyers. How do I do? Dual shot is very good. What is not good? Dance of the Devils is fine. Geese's Bidding is okay. I kind of like all this stuff in here. I'll just play 41 cards, I think. Yes, I would like to play first. Well, it's not awful. Keep. Insolent Neonate's gonna get some work in. It's not good. I need another land. I need a swamp. A swamp makes this better immensely. Turn 5, I bring in Geese's Bidding with Pale Rider of Trustad. That seems fine. So turn one, what I want to do is insolent kneeling. Turn two, probably grotesque on the instant neonate. Turn three, Farbog Revenant. Turn four, probably dual shot something of his. Okay. There's a plan. There's a plan. I do need to draw a few lands in a row. This isn't, it isn't great, but a turn one play, turn two possible play. This ramps up pretty good if I draw nothing but land. And the chances of me doing that are pretty good because I've got 16 land in the deck there. A little under half. So there's a good chance that my next, out of my next two draws, I'll draw one or two cards, one or two lands. If I draw a swamp, that's even better because there's more swamps on the deck than anything else. Swamp would be great for grotesque mutation, gain me some life so I can survive. If need be, I can always discard dual shot to draw a card with neonate. We'll see. White. His deck's a little slow too. Awesome. I'm just going to swing in with Insolent Neonate, I think. I could just go full on Pale Rider, discarding Dual Shot. That's a thought. It gets bigger problems on the field for him to kind of... I'll just leave this up for now. I don't have to make a decision right now because he's not doing anything. He probably won't do anything for another turn or two. And he does nothing. Alright, so now I'm going to consider if I want to do that. So he didn't destroy it. I think I'm just going to go full on aggro here. Gain the life, get in for more damage this turn. Next turn, if I don't get anything, Pale Rider can come out and I can throw a dual shot in the bin. He didn't play anything, so nothing for there. Alright, so I get a land. So I'm going to keep up. I'm just going to keep swinging with this. If he decides to destroy it, he decides to destroy this. And then dual shot's always the good discard here for this. Again, not sure what he's doing here, but hey, whatever. I imagine he's got a vessel in his deck. Kind of wish he'd play a little faster, though. Is my echo turned all the way up? Can you even understand a word that I'm saying right now? You probably cannot. I'm sorry. I didn't realize my echo was turned. I need to paint that so I can see the level. Does this sound better? I was probably awful to listen to. I do like this new microphone. I hope you can hear it well. I haven't watched the previous video to see how well it sounds.
I'm sure it sounds wonderful.
Oh, hey, look, he's doing something. Yeah, no, I'll attack with this. You gonna destroy it? All right. Not destroying it. Interesting. Hello. Oh. I could stretch this down a little. There. Give a little more room. Go ahead. Your lack of doing anything is kind of disturbing. Edith Chaplin. Hey, look, it's a dual shot target. Alright, so. I think I just swing in with Insolent Neonate here. Do that. And then I'll go with the Vampire Noble here. He gets his green mana. Alright, so he gets the two flyers, whatever. Veteran Cathar, sure. Land here would be awesome. I can't do both of these. Swinging with this seems fine. Swinging with this seems okay. I really wish I would have gotten mana there instead of Incorrigible Use. Because then I play Pale Rider and Geese's Bidding. I swing in and I don't care. I think I'm just going to swing in and don't care this way. If he wants to double block with these, with a spirit in this, I'm okay with that. That means I'm getting rid of at least one of his creatures. Okay. Do I care? I wipe out his entire board here with this play. I kind of just let this happen, right? Play Farbog Revenant and just pass? I think this is fine. He can only ping me for one, really. Play Firebog, pass. Another mana and Geese's Bidding happens. Okay, that's fine. I don't care about that. Griff Spoon on that. That was a hard card to pass. So his flyers is... Oh, not the right card. Alright, so I play that. Next turn, Pale Rider, Incorrigible Youths. I just do Geese's Bidding now. Sure. Okay. Can't block your flyers. You can get in for five. I can get in for four. Inspiring, well, six, seven. You're gonna swing, that's for sure. Duskwatch Recruiter, okay. Okay. four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. If he makes a mistake here and swings. Okay, swings with those two. That's fine. So I go down five. We're at 13 even. He's looking at the top three cards. He's not going to cast anything. Yeah, he's not going to cast anything here. He'd be silly to. I mean, it's bad because Griffspoon, but he has to spend most of his turn doing that next turn. Okay, you get to investigate. Sure. I still got blockers for your horde. Again, you're probably using Griffspoon on Duskwatch. Yeah. Four in the air, five in the air. But that does leave you very vulnerable, dude. Like, I'm going to get in for seven. You get in for five. I kind of win this race. Plus... Oh, you're fucking annoying. Fine. We'll do this then. Rancid Rats, deal with this shit. Now you can't attack with Inspiring Captain. I go to three. That seems stupid, dude. Fine, you got rid of that guy. You cast two spells, he becomes worse. Alright, fine. You go to five. I go to three. Yeah, he becomes worse by doing that. Yeah. Hi, Nahiri. Okay, so what kills me? Well, Duskwatch can't become. Well, exile Griffspoon. Okay. Okay. Hold back the fort. Yeah, because right now, he can't swing, except for with the spirit. And if he swings with anything on the ground, it's getting blocked. If he swings with the spirit in the air, that's fine. I'm going to plus her ability next turn anyways. All right, you're drawing a card. You probably want Duskwatch to flip. I don't think attacks here are good for you, buddy. Yeah. You know I'm playing a deck that loves to discard shit. You think this is wise? unless you have a way to prevent all damage from rancid rats, that was a bad idea. This could be tenacity. Tenacity is a possibility. If it's tenacity, Nahiri just dies. Oh, you get another spirit token. Okay, fine. We will plus discard. Awesome. I just die. There's literally no way around it. I just die because I drew land. I drew land off of land. That's pretty smug, dude. You should let me do the good game when I'm about to discard. That was kind of smug of you. That and you're fucking slow as hell. Can't block. I was not drawing anything I needed during that game. Alright, well, on to round two. I like the deck. I think it's really good. I don't have a lot of sideboard options. So that's kind of awkward. But otherwise, it's a good deck. I like it. I got another devil token. I need to look at the tokens and see what I need to bring with me per pre-release. Are these the old ones? Yeah, these are the old ones. Little Kithar, Cloistered Youth. So. Anyways, that's match one. Match two. Again, I got money, so I can't complain. And here he's good. Sorry, I just want to check something real quick here. Alright, you're gonna hear some echo. I apologize. One match two. Again, I got money, so I can't complain. Alright, I'm trying not the echo on here. Let's see what this looks like. Or sounds like. So. Sorry, I just want to check something real quick here. The sound sounds pretty good on this. Alright, you're gonna hear some echo. I apologize. Actually, I'll do that. Okay, so that's fucking annoying. Not gonna lie. Alright. Don't want that to be playing in the background. God, it resized it again. Jesus Christ. Alright, let's do this. Yes, I would like to play first. I'll turn the sounds back on so you can hear it. This is an awful hand. This is an absolutely awful hand. I have to mulligan this. This is a very fun hand. I'm keeping this. That's going on top. That Sanitarium Skeleton. Go! Cool. Next turn, Air Falkrath. Sure. You're playing a werewolf deck. That's cool. Eh. Actually, Indulgent Aristocrat's probably the right play here. No removal, one time no removal. Go ahead. Next turn I can twins. Nothing. Interesting. Alright, well. Okay. Pack Guardian. So you're getting my lifelinker. That's fine. Discarding a land. Get my skeleton. Okay. That's super awkward that I lose that, but whatever. I still gain the life. I can still block your Pack Guardian too. Well, not with Neglected Heirloom. That would be, yeah. Now that being said, I've got a flyer that's going to get in there for quite a lot of damage. Doesn't equip a Neglected Heirloom. Interesting. This screams of Howlpack Resurgence. What does that do again? Is it plus one and trample? Oh, he doesn't have it. Why didn't you equip? Okay. Maybe keeping a removal spell open? Might beyond reason. Alright, so it gets... You don't have four card types, you don't have... Oh, sure do now. Okay, so 6/5, that's a thing. 7/6. So he gets in for 7. Oh, he just kills it. Okay, well, that's... Moonlight Hunt's good. I passed that card, and I really thought about taking it. Yeah, why didn't you equip that first? Does it have trample? It does not have trample. I'll take this hit. I'm in fine shape here. I definitely attack with both. Because you can't kill him. I guess you could with Josh. Oh, wait, that does trade with that. That's fine. So you swing in again. I have lethal on board. Okay, so you played the Arsonist. That's fine. If I've got a way to get rid of that, I will. Well, that's not very fun. Yeah, it flips. Take 6 here. You can only block 1. Oh, another Arsonist? Great. I would have liked to have gotten rid of Pack Guardian. That would have been fine. Okay, so he's a 5. He's a Sin Prodder. Alright, so he was definitely sitting right next to me. Thank you. Okay. Gloom Widow. Deal 3 damage to me. Gloom Widow doesn't do anything. No. You can have it. I don't care about that. Gloom Widow doesn't really do anything. I can effectively block Gloom Widow. But whatever. Confront the unknown. Yes. Confront the unknown is an awful card for me. Probably takes 9/8 first strike. Ooh. Menace. Well, I could block it with everything. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That would... He would 9, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He'd kill everything but one. And I'd get nothing in. I believe in you, zombie. Yes. The first strike sucks. I wish you attacked with more stuff. Why didn't you? That first strike is annoying as fuck. I don't see a way around this. Well, I'm gonna try it. I mean, oh, you're just doing it to that. You don't. That really. Well, I just died. I gained 6 life. So I can take a hit from him. 9, 10, 11, 12. Yeah, I'm fine. I pretty much have to give him whatever. Okay. That flips. That's better. It's only first strike now. I take 11 from him. Inner struggle. Four to me, 10. Just concede the fucking game. Alright, well, my deck hates me. Dual shot. Does dual shot do anything? It does diddly poop. Alright, well. Yes, I would like to play first. Why do you keep resizing, game? Oh, this hand. Why? I'm gonna keep it. I should be drawing nothing but gas. Foul Orchard, okay. Take a turn off, that's fine. Farbog Revenant will come out next. Played that wrong. Depending on what he does here, it doesn't really matter how I played it. No value, sure. don't care about that so much. Sanguinary Mage, I kind of care about you. I could just wipe his board, but that kind of seems bad too. I think I just play Twins. Then he has to use some sort of removal on it. Another Sanguinary Mage, sure. Attacking seems really bad for you. Alright, well. Here I play. He can't kill it. I can get to one of his. No! He wrecks me! He wrecks me. What'd he put it on? Stuck with a sanguinary. Oh. Okay. Well, he can't attack. Kuma, sure. Attacking seems bad. Yep. Kind of want to keep that back. Do I just kill his Gloom Widow, swing in with this? If he wants to trade Stoic Builder for it, I'm okay with that. What else do I do here? Do I just Fiery Temper the Sanguinary Mage? I feel like that's the best move here. I like Gloom Widow. Hit me once. Murderous Compulsion. Yeah. Sure. Him flip. Yep. Well, seems like a good enough target for that. I gain life with that. Westvale Abbey. If he has structural distortion, this could wreck me. Well, that was really stupid of me then. Awesome. Walking. Got some arsonists? Yeah. Can't do that. Damn it! I'm seriously gonna lose with Nahiri and with goddamn Westvale Abbey. I just lose. I lose! I cannot fucking believe this. Probably just walk away from this too. I don't even. I. Good. I've won. I see that the last place person, Kyle Bradshaw, has dropped. So in the third round, I will get a bye. I will get a win. I win a match. I'm so frustrated right now because I got two really good cards, and they. Couldn't win. Anyways, I'm going to stop here. I've only been streaming for an hour and a half. Do I put myself through that again? No, I'm not feeling it tonight. I'm going to just go ahead. No one's watching anyways right now, so it's not a big deal. I'm going to go ahead and stop the stream tonight. Thank you for joining me. I really appreciate you listening to me on Echo as long as you did. I apologize for that. I will keep a better eye on that. I'm going to paint the little knob on here so I can see where, because right now I can't see where it's at on the scale for the Echo. So I really appreciate whoever joined and listened and stayed for that. I appreciate that. I will be streaming again on Tuesday, so definitely catch me for that. My plan is on Tuesday. I will not be doing Mitka this time. Not be doing Magic the Gathering. I have other plans. I don't want to spoil them yet. But the other plans are going to work. So it's going to be awesome. So definitely come and join me. Oh, looks like they're going to third round now. I'm going to be paired up. Really? Lanaval? You lost and you dropped. Shit. I don't get the automatic win, I don't think. No, I don't. I can't face him, so I'm either Fogman, who's an asshole, and I've dealt with him before, or Rumpsteak is who I'm going to face. I dislike this a lot. So I guess I'm streaming for a little while longer. I was ready to wrap up and head out and have some dinner and de-stress from this. I guess I get to play around with Nahir and watch as Mikko screws me over. So there's that. Yeah, this will be fun. Thank you, Lanval, who beat me in the first round. Thank you for dropping, you asshole. Oh, no, you didn't drop. You absolutely lost connection. So I'm going to have to play this out, probably lose. The way this is going, I will probably lose. Which is stupid because I've got great pulls. I have great cards in this deck. I have a really good vampire deck. And I'm not seeing the vampires. I'm not seeing the cards. Here we go. Round three. Rumpsteak. Well, of the two, I'd rather face him. Sure, I'll keep this. What? Toppelgeist. Awesome. I could just murderous compulsion him. Swing in for one, and he's done with Toppelgeist. That actually seems fine. Toppelgeist is disgusting. He's probably got Puncturing Light. Nope. Next turn, I can call the Bloodline. Or Farbog Revenant. I'm going to go ahead and Stone Quarry here. Swing in. It'd be fun to get the skeleton next turn. It'd be fun to draw the skeleton. Because the skeleton is pretty much the third part of this combo that really makes us fun. Falconwrath Gorger. Oh, that is a card I could have used. Alright, so it's a 2-1. Sure. Ooh, it would be fun to get Tormenting Voice. Fiery Temper would be fun. Three mana. What you doing? Angelic Purge. Okay, well, that's fine. Now you get me the skeleton. Now you get me the skeleton. Awesome. Well, that's not a horrible play, but I think the play here is Sanitarium Skeleton. And yes. Because what I'll do is I'll block with the skeleton to Falconwrath Gorger should he decide to be stupid enough and attack. Okay. What's your targeting? Probably a skeleton. That's fine. So you get in for 5. Although that seems like a bad attack for you, but hey. Sure. Sure. Okay. Cool. This returns it. So I can 3, 4. Go ahead and return it this turn. Well, shitsky. I tapped that wrong. No mana available, so I'm going to go ahead and swing in with the Insolent Mutiny. He's probably got Nihiri's Machinations. Now, that being said, I'll block Falconrath Gorger with this. Unless you play an Eye of Voldaren Duelist, Incredible Youths. Sure. I'm going to take some beats here. The Sanitarium Skeleton. Cool. All right, let's do this right. Play this. How badly do I want to draw cards here? I think I want to do it. Nope, I sure don't. But I do want to attack with Lifelink. That was really stupid of me. I could have blocked Incorrigible Youths with the... I could have taken a lot less damage last turn. So 5. Alright. Yep, do that. So I take 5 here. Drifter. Well, it's a blocker. It's not a good blocker. It's actually a very dead blocker. Now, here's the real question. He's got one card in hand. I can just get rid of Voldaren Duelist. Well, the swamp comes out, sure. I get Sanitarium Skeleton back. I go ahead and play it. And I deadweight this. Block with the Moorland Drifter. Okay. Gets in for 4. My lifelinker becomes a 4. I like this plan so far. This is working. Is this working for you? Okay. Okay. So I take 4. All right, so now play the skeleton. To have 2 mana left, pitch that. I want 2 more cards. Oh, okay, well. So I came back 4. At some point, he's gonna. Okay. Sure. That's awful for me, but whatever. Block the biggest thing. Okay. So, blockers for all your stuff now. Got a bit of a headache today. Westvale Abbey is very interesting in this situation. I really need to draw another creature spell next turn. Okay. What you doing here? Spiteful motives. Well, fuck. Why do you have to have that? Alright, well, I get rid of one of his creatures. Of course, Dad. Thank you. Eleven of my lands, so there's only 6 lands left. I'm drawing nothing but gas here. I definitely am just gonna have to chump here. He's gonna get in for 2. Why didn't you attack with both? There's no way. Game on. Deck, you've got a bunch of creatures. Any of them would be great here. Alright, pay 1. Yeah, you knew where that was going quickly. Alright, so he's got red. Dual shot is really good in this. What's not good? Encourageable use is fine. Twins is fine. I kind of need the tormenting voice. Olivia Bloodsworn, hey! Girl, where are you? Why haven't you shown up? I'm going to go with 41. Oh, why do you keep doing this? Mikko. I'm going to keep. Oh, wow. 5? Are you going to 4? No, you're not going to 4. So, insolent neonate first. Not gonna trade with you there. Whirlwind Drifter. Probably don't attack. Which I'm okay with. Ravenous Bloodsucker. So, don't attack because you've got good blocks. You probably do this, although this is, seems like a bad idea, but sure. 2, 3, well, you have to pay 2 to get to kill him. And honestly, I don't care. I say he has to attack. Okay. Discard Forbidden Sanctuary. I'm gonna kill your ass first. Sure. I'm gonna trade at the very least here. Take 3, 6, which is awful, not gonna lie. Alright, so I just play out the rats here, because that gets rid of his creature. He's done one card. Actually, and I play Insolent Neonate as well here. Play both those. Now he has to draw something. He's got really bad attacks now, and he's got to attack, so... Yeah, you got to attack! And I will happily trade the Rancid Rats for it. Do something stupid or pump it. Town Gossip Monger, another one of those, sure. Unruly Mama, sure. If I get Westvale Abbey out, you're probably in trouble here. Well, that'll work. Neither of these are good ideas for you. I can make this kill both your creatures. I can make this kill both your creatures. You have to block with both. It's got menace. Yeah, you have to block with both. Because I think I just keep up grotesque mutation. No matter what, you're gonna double block there. All right, so I definitely want Unruly Mob to die. They'll both die. Okay, that changes literally nothing. Yep. And you take 3. And I've got Geese's Bidding for next turn. While you're sitting here doing nothing. Yay, I won the match. All right, that's a better end to that. Didn't seem to hear any, so that kind of sucks. I did get paired up, and I beat the pair up. So that's kind of fun. So that was better. That felt better. I should have done a lot better than that. So I was not getting the draws I needed. So I'm going to leave it here. I've been streaming now for a couple hours. I hope you join me on Tuesday when I'll be streaming again. Like I said, I have plans. It is not Magic the Gathering Online. I'm going to do a game I purchased on Steam. I don't know which one just yet, but I will not be spoiling it until probably about a half hour before I start streaming on Tuesday. Another possibility, I might stream on Sunday. That might be MechGo, or it might be Minecraft. Who knows? It kind of depends on if I'm doing anything that day. So, until next time, everyone, DFTBA.